Hello friends, it's Prajwal Pathak this side and you're watching my YouTube channel Pi Guru. Friends, today in this tutorial we are going to talk about Google Colab. Okay, now see, this is first video in our GPython series. Now in GPython series we'll be mainly talking about Google services and that we can use using Python, like Google Maps, Google Colab, Google Sheets, Google Docs and Google Drive, like these things. Okay, but using Python. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, what is Google Colab? In this tutorial we'll be taking a walkthrough of Google Colab. Okay, so what is Google Colab? Basically it's an online Jupyter notebook environment system which you can use to write and run codes in Python. Okay, now if you are not familiar with Jupyter notebooks, basically it's a self-based editor where you can write your code in parts and run it. Okay, now if you are a beginner, Google Colab may be the most best way to write and run codes in Python and learn Python. Okay, now see, what is the main use of Google Colab? Basically it is used to run code online. Okay, see, Google Colab will run in your browser, so keep in mind this thing, that you will need active internet connection to run codes in Google Colab. Secondly, it will run in your browser, so you can use any browser, whether you are using Chrome, Firefox or Opera, doesn't matter. All you have to do is just open your Google Colab. Okay, now see, Google Colab stores and you store your files over cloud, or mainly your file that you will create will be stored in your Google Drive. Okay, now it's free. It does not require any setup. You do not have to install Python, you do not have to install Google Colab, you do not have to install even Python packages. Google Colab provide lot of packages, Python packages pre-installed with it, so you do not have to install them even, and you can start just writing your codes, okay, without worry. Now Google Colab is mainly used for machine learning engineers because it supports a lot of heavier Python libraries like TensorFlow, Keras, etc. Okay, but you can use it even when you are a beginner. Now it's free, so you can access it. All you need is two things: first a Gmail ID, and second is a active internet connection. So let's see, here I am in my Chrome browser and let's see, try to open Google Colab. Okay, the URL of Google Colab is colab.research.google.com. see here, it's auto typing colab.research.google.com. just press enter and it will redirect us to the home page of Google Colab. So let it get open. Since I'm opening it for the first time, it will take few seconds, but after that it will run smoothly. So what you have to do, just simply cancel it from here. Okay, now see, Google it doesn't matter whose system, which system you are using, you can access Google Colab from any system. Okay, so you do not have to worry about installation of Python. It doesn't matter whether you are with your own PC or not, you can access Google Colab just by visiting this URL. Okay, colab.research.google.com. so let it get opened and then we will create a file and start writing codes. So this is the home page of Google Colab, which is saying that what is collaborative Colab. So the full form of Colab is collaboratory for short, allows you to write and execute Python in a browser with zero configuration required, free access to GPUs. GPU stand for graphical processing unit. So if you are using lots of images in your, or if you are working with lots of images in your Python code, you can simply access GPUs. Again, it's free. It's very easy to share. Okay, now you can think Google Colab just like Jupyter notebook environment. Okay, now see here, it has given few examples how to write and run codes in Google Colab, but don't worry, I'll be showing them in a minute. So first of all, let's go to files and create a new file for us so that we can write codes. So just go to file and create new notebook. Okay, and it will create a new notebook for us. Now notebook is a system where we write codes in cells. What is cells? I'll be showing it in a minute. So let it get opened. Since I'm opening it first time, so it's, that's why it's taking time, but it's very smooth later, and if you have very good connection, internet connection, it will work very fast too. Okay, so let it get open first, checking out data. Okay, so this is the display or UI that will appear when you create a new notebook. Okay, so before writing code, let me show you several settings that you can try to make Google Colab more user friendly. So just go here and select settings from, or this gear icon, and under site you can select this theme of this whole Jupyter Colab. So you can either prefer choose between dark or light. I prefer dark, so I'll select simply dark. Then go to editor. Okay, here are a few settings that you can try. The colorization of this sales, which is default dark or monokai. I'll simply use default dark. And then there are a few things that you can try. That is, first check this thing. It will not automatically checked, so you have to check it first. Automatically trigger code completions. Okay, it will help you to auto complete your code, so you do not have to type everything. Then indentation with in spaces. So initially it will be two. Okay, so two spaces will be used for indentation, but select four. Okay, it will be better. And then select this thing. So line numbers. Okay, so along with code, see here, it's also rewriting the line numbers. So okay, so just selecting this, just go to save, save it, and see on the left hand side it's saying get untitled 0.ipynb. Now what is ipynb? Ipynb stands for IPython notebook. So if you are a Jupyter user, you might be knowing that the file used for saving a Jupyter notebook is also .ipynb. Okay, so it is also the Google Colab files are also stored in, saved in ipynb format. So you can easily import your Google Jupyter notebook files in Google Colab, or you can easily export your Google Colab files in Jupyter notebooks. Okay, so you can work seamlessly between them. Now just go here and click here untitled 0, and let me just change its name test. Okay, just give it any name so we can work with this name. Okay, now it's test.ipynb. Also see on the left hand side it's showing a drive icon. This means that the file that we'll be creating will be stored in your Google Drive. Now see, Google Drive provides you 15 GB of free storage, so you can work with as much Python files as you want. Now see, here's the first thing that we are getting is a cell. This is a cell. Here we will be writing codes, and to run your Python code, simply just select here or press Control Enter. Okay, so let me just go here, and before writing code, let me tell you a very simple thing that will make you the master of Google Colab. Okay, see, there are three things that you have to keep in mind. First, there is a code cell. This is a code cell. You can create code cells from here, or you can simply press Control MB to create a new code cell. Then there is a text cell. See here, let me just go here. See, this is a text cell. Okay, and here this is a code cell. Here we can write codes. This is a text cell. This here we can write text, or you can write documentation about your code, so another user can learn what your code is doing. And there is one more thing, and we call it section header cell. Basically, inside section header cell you can write one type of codes. So just let go to insert and select this section header cell. So just select it, and it will create a section for us. See, it's saying that new section. So what you have to do, you can move all the cells up and down from here. See, on the right hand side there's an up arrow or down arrow key. So let me just move this section upward. Okay, so it will make the section go upward. Now just double click it, and here I'll be writing basic Python programs. Okay, so in this section we'll be writing basic Python programs. Then we will create some more sections, where we'll be writing working with web scraping and image manipulation, or data analysis and visualization like things. Okay, so just unselect it and just go to this code cell again. And now this select this text cell. Okay, in this text cell we can write some documentation about your code. Again, make it move upward. So here in this text cell we'll be writing a simple addition program, a simple addition program in Python. Okay, see, it's a so in Python. And now let's just go to code cell and start writing your code. So how can you write code? You can simply write any Python code that you write in Python IDEs or text editor. So let me just create a simple addition program, print 2 plus 2. Okay, it's a simple program, and to run it simply press Control Enter, or from select this click this thing to run this program. Okay, and what it will do, it will run our code. See, for the first time it will take time, and again it will run smoothly, and let it get executed first. Then we'll write some more programs. Okay, and some advanced programs. Then we'll work with images, then we'll work with CSV files, and draw a graph using matplotlib. So let it get run. So see, we are getting an output of 4. Now to create another text cell, code cell, just press Control MB. So before writing code, let's create a text cell, and so that we can write a document about our code, what our code is doing. So let me just make it move upward, and it says that in this here we'll be writing random number generator program, a random number generator program Okay, so this program will generate random numbers for us. So let's create a program which can generate random numbers for us. Now see, to for this we have to import a module called random module. So let me just import it. Okay, now let's create a for loop for I in range 5. Okay, since I need 5 numbers, so I'll loop this create this loop for 5 times, and let's create a variable num. Inside this num variable, let's create store a random number, random dot rand int. Let's say 1, 100. What it will do, it will simply choose a random number between 1 and 100 and store it in this num variable. Finally, let's print num. And to run it, again press Ctrl Enter and it will run this code. See, now it's working very fast. So it's saying that we have got 5 random numbers, 90, 15, 75, 27, 23. Working fine. Now let's create again a new cell, which is you can create either by selecting this or by pressing Ctrl MB. So Control MB means Control Make Below. Okay, you can use Control MA to create a code cell above it. Okay, so before this, create a text cell so that we can write a document about code, and let it move upward by clicking this up arrow key. And this time let's create a square root finder program. So a square root finder program. What this program will do, it will find the square root of the given number user inputs. Okay, so what it is, first of all let's create a module import math which we will be using to find the square root of the given number. So let's create a variable num and ask user input here, int input, enter a number. See, everything you have to write the same way that you write in normal Python, so you do not have to worry about. Now let's create a variable root and find the square root of this number variable. So how can we do it? Math.sqrt, this is a function which helps us to find the square root of this number, and let's pass this num variable. Finally, what we'll be doing, we'll be printing this root variable, print square root of comma num is root. Okay, we have stored it in root variable. So let's just run this program by pressing Ctrl Enter, and first of all it will ask us for a user input. See, it's saying that enter a number, so let's pass just 9 and press Enter, and it will show us the square root of 9 is 3.0. okay, so this is how you can create a square root finder program. Now let's create work with files. Okay, text files. How can we work with text files? Let's press Ctrl MB. It will generate a new code cell for us. And before writing code, let's create a text cell from here so that we can write a document about our code, and let's make it move upward. Okay, so double click it to edit it, and here type read and write. See, there are a few things that you can try. You can make this text bold by selecting it, italic by selecting it. You can insert links in this text blocks, text cells. You can insert images for this text cell. You can insert videos. You can insert lists like this. Okay, you can select text or toggle heading to make this text bigger in size. Okay, reading and writing files. Okay, so reading and writing files, text files, let's say text files. Okay, and go here, let's create a text file for us. So how can we create a text file? It's very easy in Python to create a text file with open. Let's say my text file name will be hello.txt, so I'll simply pass hello.txt. And let's pass w here. W means in write mode, so if you pass w mode, it will create a text file for you as f. And let's finally write something in this text file, f.write. Let's say hello world, and then write one more line, f.write. This text file is created using Google Colab. Okay, so let's just run it and it will create a text file for us. So let's just run it and let it get executed, and it will create a text file for us. See, we are not getting any output, so it doesn't matter. It's not that we haven't created a file. Let's create a new text cell for here, code cell here. You can also select a code cell from here and type this code for exclamation mark ls and just run it, and you will see a hello.txt file appearing here. See, here we are getting a hello.txt file. It means that we have successfully created this text file. You can see also see this text file by going this thing, selecting this thing on the left hand side, which is saying there's files. Okay, so just click it, and it will say it's saying that a sample data folder, which is provided by default by Google Colab, which you can use to, it has several CSV files which you can use to work with as an example, and see here we have a hello.txt file that we have just created. So just double click it, and it will show the content of this text file on the right hand side. See, it's saying that hello world, this is a this text file is created using Google Colab. Okay, so keep in mind, let me just remove it and put a slash n here. So it will make a new line. So again, to run this text cell, just press Ctrl N. And okay, now let's just go here, and if you want to remove this, just remove it like this. And now let's read the content of this text file using Python code. So again, you have to type the same code. Just do it here like this, Ctrl C, copy it, paste it here. To read the text file, we open it in R mode. So just pass R here, and let's create a variable data and pass f.read here. Okay, and finally print data, and just run this program by pressing Ctrl Enter, and it will show the content of this text file. See, now it's saying that hello world, this text file is created using Google Colab. Okay, so this is how you can work with or create or work with text files in Google Colab. Keep in mind, this text file is stored in this notebook, or it's online. Okay, so it's not available offline. You can download it, and we'll be learning how can we download files from Google Colab in a minute, so don't worry. Now let's create a new section for us, section header cell, and let's pass it's saying that new section. So double click it to edit the text, and here in this section we'll be working with web scraping and data visualization. So web scraping and data visualization. Okay, so in the first section we work with common basic Python programs that we do normally using Python. So in this section we are working with web scraping and data visualization. Now let's create a text cell, and in that text cell you can write any text about or document about your code. So this is a simple script to download images from internet. Okay, press Ctrl MB to create a text code cell, and here import request. Now request is a library which you can use to access some website data. See, in Python normally request library is not available by default, so you have to first install it, but Google Colab simply provides you by default, so you do not have to install request library. Beautiful. So for library like numpy, matplotlib, these are available by default, so you do not have to install it. Okay, so now let's see here. I have my blog opened here. Okay, and in this blog I have stored several images. So let's say, suppose if I want to download some image, how can we do it? It's very easy. So let's just scroll down. Suppose I want to let's say download this image. Okay, so just select it and just right select it on it and open it in a new file. See, this is the image that I want to download. I have opened it in just full format. Okay, so what you have to do, just copy this URL. Let's just copy it. Let's go to our text file. Okay, and let's create a variable URL and paste this URL that we have just copied inside keywords. Okay, so we have pasted it. Now what you have to do, we have to download this file. So first of all, we will save it into Google Colab, and then we'll learn how can we download it. So it's very easy. Let's create a variable R, and inside request library we have a function called the get function, which takes a URL and visit that particular URL and gives us a required data. So R equals request dot get URL. It will visit this particular image URL, and now let's see how can we save this image. Now see how we created a text file. It was very easy with open hello.txt WSF. Similarly, to create an image file, we have to again create a file. So let's see how can we do it with open. Let's say my image name will be image.jpg, but this time we'll be writing it in a binary mode. Keep in mind, images, audios, videos, these are binary files, whereas text files are just normal text files. Okay, to create a image, you have to open it in write binary mode as f, and then what we are going to do, f.write. See, this r, we can apply a method on this r variable, that is r.content, and it will save this particular image for us. So let's just run it by pressing Ctrl Enter, and it will just save this particular image in our Google Colab. Now let's see. Press Ctrl MB And let's open this image that we have just saved in Google Colab. How can we open an image in Google Colab? It's very easy. Type this thing from IPython. See, to open this particular image in here inside this environment, notebook environment, you have to type this thing from IPython. This library is not available in by default in Python, normal Python. Okay, you cannot access this library in normal Python, but it's available in Jupyter notebooks and this Google Colab. So from IPython, import image. Okay, type import image, and inside the image just pass your image name. See, my image name is image.jpg, so I'll just pass image.jpg. So let's just press enter, and it will open the particular image that we have saved. We have an error here. If you import is failing due to missing packages, you can cannot import name image. Okay, oops, actually I have a error here. It will be display. So ipython.display import image. So let's just again run it, and it will open the particular image that we have just saved here inside this environment. So let's run it. So this is the image that we have just saved. See, we have worked successfully saved this image in here. So you can also clear your particular output from here. Okay, so let me just clear this output. Oops, actually I've again run it, sorry, my fault. Just stop it from here. Okay, so again we got output. This may just clear it. Now what we are working with here, web scraping and data. Oh sorry, just edit the section header cell. Okay, section name. Here we will be working with web scraping and let's say image manipulation. What we are going to do, see, the file that we have just created, you can also get it from here. Go to file, click this file save thing, and you will be able to see a image.jpg here. So you can double click it to and it will open on the right hand side, but I don't want that thing. So what we are going to do, we have created this file, and now this is a colored image. What I'm going to do, I'm going to use Python and make this file in black and white. So let's see how can we do it. So let's create a control new code cell for us, and here let's type from PIL. Now PIL is stands for Pillow Library import image. Okay, and type, press enter and enter. Let's create a variable img and open this image, image.open. Let's say image.open. We have to particularly open this image, which name is image.jpg, and let's see how can we convert into black and white. Simply you have to type image.img.convert. img is our object name, and so img.convert, and let's pass L here. L stands for black and white, so just pass L and apply the save method on it. So let's save it by the name wb or bw, black and white image.jpg. See, you can pass jpg, png, anything here, and it will just save the file in that particular format. And see, we are done. So just run it, control enter. And now let's try opening this bw image using Python. So just pass bw here and run this cell, particular cell, and it will open the black and white image that we have just generated. See, this is the image that we have converted in black and white using Python. Okay, so this is how you can work with images and image manipulation. Now let's create a text cell here, and we are going to work with some other thing here. Just double click it, and scraping currency exchange rates from internet. See, we are going to work with we'll write a program which will convert United States dollars in all other currencies. Okay, find the currency exchange rate of a United States dollar in other currencies. Let's see how can we do it. Again, we are going to import the request library, import request, and this time let's create a variable from C. Inside the from C variable, you can pass any currency name. Suppose I want to convert from US United States dollars to other currencies, so I'll simply type USD. If you are Indian, you can pass INR here, and then we have a particular URL that you have to type. C, just pass this variable https colon double forward slash API dot exchange rate dash API, exchange rate dash API, and then dot com. sorry .com/v4/latest then slash, okay, then type plus and then type from c. okay, from c is this variable. So what it will do, it will create a URL, but in the end it will store this particular string. If it's USD, it will store USD here. If it's INR, it will store INR here, like this. Okay, now let's again, we are going to make a request. How can we make a request? Simply r equals request dot get. Now this is I am using exchange rate API. You can use any API here, just pass URL variable here. Now let's create a variable data, and this if you visit this URL, it will respond you with a JSON file. So let's just extract the JSON file from here and let's just print data, and press Control Enter, and it will open a JSON file here. So let's see it. See, we are getting a JSON file. It's saying that base is USD, the date we run this command on is 6/3/2020, last time it was updated on this timestamp. Okay, then it's saying that in 1 USD we have 1 USD, in 1 USD we have 3.672077 AED, like this thing. Let's see how much INR are in 1 United States dollar. So just scroll to INR, find INR here. Where is INR? See, in 1 United States dollar it is 73.357231 Indian national rupees. Okay, so let me just clear this output. And what we are going to do, we are going to extract the only currency thing from this particular data dictionary. So how can we do it? Let's create a variable rates and pass data of rate. Okay, so rates, and this time print rates only instead of data. We are going to print rates. Press Control Enter and it will extract the particular larger dictionary from the smaller dictionary. See, initially we were getting some more things like base and date and this thing, but this time we are only getting the dictionary which is storing the exchange rates. So in 1 USD we have 1 USD, and in 1 USD we have 3.672077 AED. And now I don't know what is the full form of AED. You can just search. Now suppose if I want to loop through this dictionary, how can we do it? Simply, it's again very easy. So for let's say currency code C code comma rate in this dictionary, which is rates dot items, let's print C code colon rate and just press enter. And suppose I want to make this line particular line comment, how can you make a particular line comment in Colab? Just press Control and forward slash and it will make the particular line go comment. Okay, so let's just run this cell by pressing Control Enter, and it will now loop through this particular dictionary. So it's saying that 1 USD is equals 1 and 1 USD is equal to 73.357231 INR. Okay, so this is how you can loop through a dictionary in Python. So if you want to clear this output, just clear it from here. Now let's create a text cell again, or let's create another section. So I think you have got enough idea of how to open images in Colab or make requests. So let's create a new section here, selecting here, and just type data visualization visual. See, I have, my English is very bad, so sorry for my mistakes. Data visualization and analysis. Okay, I think I'm forgetting one thing. I didn't told you how to download images in Google Colab. Okay, so one thing that you can try is to go here, or you can download any file just by using this method. Suppose if you want to download this file that you have created to your disk drive, you can just right click on it and select download. Okay, and suppose if you want to download it using Python code, how can you do it? So just press Control Enter here. Oops, sorry, my fault. Not Control Enter, we have to press Control MB. Okay, so to get a new code cell. So here we have got a code cell. Suppose I want to download this black and white image. So what I can do, type this in from google.colab import files. Okay, and then type sorry, control J and type file dot download, and inside this type your file name. See, we have created three files here. We have created a text file, hello.txt, we have created image file bw image.jpg, and then image.jpg. suppose I want to download bw image.jpg, so I'll simply type bw image.jpg, and if you run this particular cell, you will be able to download this particular file to your disk drive. Okay, so let it get executed, and it will, you will see it got downloaded on my system. See here, it's downloaded. Okay, so this is how you can download images. Now we'll also be learning how can we upload images or other things. So just let's create a text cell. So inside text cell we can write, let's say, a graph between numbers and their respective squares. So we are going to make a graph for us. So just let's press Ctrl MB to create a code cell for us. And here let's type import numpy as np. okay, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, sorry, as plt. Now let's create a variable x, basically this will be an array, np.arrange 1, 11, 1. Now this will create an array, store it in x variable. Now x variable will store an array from the numbers from 1 to 10. Okay, see, 11 will not be included, and this inside y we can do this thing. Okay, let's try printing x and y. So see what's inside x and what's inside y. Okay, so let's just press enter, and basically what it will do, inside x it's an array 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, which is storing this thing, and inside y we pass the square of x. So it will extract each element from it and store its square in this y variable. See, again we have got array 1 4 9 16, which is simply the square of these elements, respective elements. Okay, so let me just remove this thing and clear this outputs first. So let's just remove it. We are going to create a graph for this. So okay, so how can we do it? plt.scatter, pass x comma y here, and then on the x axis, x label, we are going to do this thing, plt.xlabel, and just pass numbers here. plt.ylabel, on the y axis we are going to type squares, and let's say plt dot, the title of this graph will be title, the title of this graph will be let's say growth of squares, growth of number and their squares. Okay, you can type anything, you can give this graph any name, any title. So we have this thing, and now what we are going to do, basically we are going to first plot this plt.plot by using plt.plot, and then we are going to show it. So plt.show. So let's just press enter, control enter, and it will generate a graph for us. See, so see here, we have successfully created a graph. It says the growth of numbers and their squares. On the y label we have squares written, on the x label we have numbers written, on the x axis we have the x numbers, which are 1, 2, 2 up to 10, and the y axis we have their respective squares. So see, the square of 2 is 4, the square of 4 is 16, which is something less than 20. Okay, like this. Suppose if we want to change the color of this particular dots, which is square, how can you do it? You can just pass color variable here, and inside it you can pass red to make the scatters red. Just press again, run this particular cell, and it will generate a graph for us. Okay, so like this. Now again, if you want to download this graph, how can you do it? Simply you can download using the same thing that we have just did here. First of all, you have to do one thing. Instead of plt.show, you have to pass plt.save. okay, and inside this you have to give your graph a name, and then you can do the same thing that we did to download our image. Okay, so from google.colab import files, file download your graph name. Okay, so this is how you will be able to download a graph, particular graph. Now let's go here and create a text file for us, and let's see how can you import a file from your disk drive to Google Colab. So again, we are going to do the same thing. First of all, write this thing, importing a CSV file in Google Colab. So let's create a code cell for us. Now see, I am importing a CSV file, but you can import any file using this method. You can import an image, you can import a a text file, you can import a graph, you can import a CSV file, anything like this using the same thing. So from google.colab import, what we are going to import, files, this thing. Okay, so files dot, first of all let's create a variable, upload equals files dot upload. This method will create a option for us, so let's just run it and you will see a thing will appear for us which will say to upload some files. So see, it's saying that choose file. So using this choose files, you can select any file from your drive. So suppose I want to, here I have a CSV file, top restaurants in Kanpur, and I want to upload this thing. So I'll simply upload this thing, press open here, and it will upload the particular CSV file in Google Colab. Okay, now let's try reading this thing. Okay, that we have just uploaded CSV file, let's try reading it. How can we do it? Again, we have to import pandas first. So import pandas as pd. okay, let's create a data frame for us, df. Let's give the name df equals pd dot read csv and pass the name of the particular CSV file here. Copy this thing. Okay, copy this name, pass it here. Okay, you can try one more method to upload files. Go to here. Okay, you can select upload from here. See, we have a file uploaded here, top restaurants in Kanpur or in .csv. You can select this upload thing from here to upload a file. And finally, let's just print df.read to see the content of this. Let's just print data frame to see the content of this particular CSV file. So it's saying that empty data frame, unnamed, zero ratings. Okay, it's saying that it's empty. Okay, so basically it may happen that it does not is having anything. So choose, let's again run this. So control enter, choose file, my file. Let's see if I have some other CSV. I have one more CSV file which is 3KB in size. So let's upload this thing. Okay, instead of uploading, so instead of Kanpur, it will be Varanasi from here. So Varanasi, if I'm not wrong. So let's just run this time, this cell, particular cell, and it will read the content of this file. Okay, so see, we have correctly reading the content of this particular CSV file. You can also this see the content of the CSV file. Just going here, double selecting this particular CSV file, and it will open the contents on the right hand side. Let me just close this thing. And you can read CSV files on the left hand side also. So you can just expand it from here. So you can see this is the content of CSV file, and pandas has correctly read this contents. Okay, so this is how you can read CSV files, upload any file. By CSV file I mean this is how you can upload any file on your system in Google Colab. Okay, see, uploading and downloading will be learning them in detail in some other video, and so for this time it's enough. Okay, so now let's create an insert and press section header cell, and it will create a section header cell for us. And let's just type here commands, and let's create a text file, a text cell for us. And see, why actually we are creating these things, section cells? We can actually just minimize them from here. Okay, so it's a good way to, if you want to minimize your code, you can just minimize from it here, selecting this down arrow, and you can also again maximize it from again selecting this thing. Okay, so this is how you can minimize this particular section cells. So let's just double click it, some commands to try in Colab. Okay, so let's create this code cell, or you can do it the same thing by pressing Ctrl MB. How to delete a cell? Ctrl MD will delete the cell. Okay, so first of, the first command is ls command. It will show you all the files that you have uploaded or created in this particular Colab. So see, there are few files. First of all, vw image.jpg, image.jpg, top response in kanpur.csv, hello.txt. Sample data is a default data file that is given by Colab, okay, and then top response in kanwaransi.csv. okay, so these are the files that we have created or uploaded. Then you can pass date command and press enter. It will show us the current date. Similarly, if you want to actually date, not data, my fault, it's what's saying the command, not fault. It will show the date. Okay, these are the commands that you run in normal CMD. Okay, if you are using exclamation mark, it means that you have to run this particular command in your command prompt. Okay, and suppose if you want to some library which is not available in Colab, so what you can do, you can simply type pip install particular library name. Suppose I want to install pip install request, so I'll simply type pip install request, so and press control enter, and it will try installing this particular thing. But see, I have already this Colab already installed, request library already installed in Colab, so it will say requirement already satisfied. Okay, so this is how you can install pip packages using pip in Colab. Okay, so this is how you run some commands. Now see, in the next video we'll be learning how can we upload and download files or from Google Colab. And by that means, see, I have shown you only the one way to download and upload files, but in the next video we'll be learning in detail. You can also use your Google GitHub profile, you can also use your My Drive to upload and download files, okay, like this thing. And see, as in the beginning I said, there are two ways to create a file in Google Colab. So the first way was to obviously visit the home page, and the second way is just visit your Google Drive. Okay, go there and see, if you've tried this way, a folder will be created in your Google Drive by the name Colab Notebooks. Automatically it will store all the notebooks of your Google Drive, Colab, in one particular folder. And so let's just it get opened and we'll see. See, there are few files that I have generated. This test.ipynb is the current file that we are working in. Suppose if you want to create a new file, you can just simply go to new, okay, and press go to here more and select Google Collaborate, okay, and it will create a new Google Collab file for us. And suppose if you want to open a file into Google Collab, just right click on the particular file name, okay, and go to select this open with and select Google Collaboratory, and it will open the particular notebook in Google Collaboratory. So let's see it, and we are nearly done with the tutorial. So in some other tutorial we will also learn how to upload and download our ipynb file, so you can work it in Jupyter notebooks or something like that, okay. But in some other video, I think this is enough for a particular this video. So let's see, let's run it. Okay, also one thing, let's just go to test. Suppose if you are working with heavier images, so you can just do one more thing, select one thing for here, edit, just go to runtime I think, and then there was one thing that I want to show you. What was that thing? Control P, code cell, scratch code cell view, edit. I think I'm not seeing this particular thing, so don't worry, I'll be showing it in some other video if I get why it's not able to. Actually I think my internet connection got slow, that's why it's not opening the particular notebook for us. But don't worry, it's simply a notebook, another notebook. Okay, I think it is opening it, table.ipynb. It's slow because of my slow internet connection, but don't worry, it will work fast for you. My system also hangs a little. Actually I'm using both my Chrome and a screen recorder, that's why my system hangs, but it runs very fast, so don't worry. And Colab, according to me, is the best way for a beginner to run Python. Okay, so you do not have to install anything, you know, and see this thing, see also this thing, command, go to command palette, and it will show you the several things that you can try. Add a comment, you can press control alt m. It has several shortcuts written here which you can try, okay, so related to the commands which you can try if you want, then only, okay. So I think, see, this is the file that we have So it's saying that num int input and number. So let's just run it. Okay, it's another file that I have created before to teach a person. So it's saying that int enter a number. Actually, I have already run it. We have created text file. We have read it data. Okay, so this is how you can create new files. Okay, so let's try printing 10. Let's run this thing, this particular cell. Oops, control enter to run this particular cell. Actually, I think it's taking a lot of time, so I think this is enough for this particular video. Okay, so don't worry, I'll be teaching the thing that I wanted to show you. I'll be showing you in some other video. So this is it for this video, guys. If you like this video, leave a like or a dislike. If you're new to my channel, subscribe it. Thank you. See you in